Eldegoss electric bass made in Japan. I smell a lawsuit. Anyway, apparently this is 40 plus years old. Many things to do today. Apple is going to go leave the building. Bridge is going away with something more traditional, and that way we can put the cover bling covers back on it. And there's a complaint about something with the electronics, so before I take the strings off it, oh, we're going to clean up the frets as well. Before I take the strings off it, let's just plug it in and see what it's doing. I really like the neck on this bass, and it looks really freaking straight and good. So what sounds does it make? Volume. Oh. And it cuts in and out. Okay. Could be just some shit in the controls. Could need a new control, but we'll investigate that once I get the strings off it. Okay, what do we got? A lot of bad shielding. Just for the record, folks, this is a humbucker. It doesn't make noise, or shouldn't, and this is probably making things worse. We got a wire, which I'm not sure where it goes, because it goes under the pickups somewhere. Let's remove the pickups, and let's just get rid of all that shielding, because I got a feeling something's touching the bad shielding when you wiggle the pot. So we got a remnant of a brown wire. We got this weird brown wire. We got this one that sort of fell off when I opened it up, so that's coming out, and let's just get rid of this. It doesn't do anything anyway. Actually, I digress. It might do something if it was done properly, but the shielding has to come up over the top of the cavity, and it has to come in contact with that. So if you really want to do this right, you do this over so it goes to the edge, not just this little grounding strip that they used. Oh goodness, away we go. Wow, pretty scientific there, guys. So we got this. That's what the little brown wire is. I don't know what that is. We're going to get rid of that. That's another ground wire that attaches to the shielding, which, if this is touching that, that would be touching that anyway. This has all got to go. Stand by. Well, we can't get it to fail on the bench. So maybe one of those silly wires floating around in there, or the bad shielding, or whatever. I'm going to put some cleaner into the controls. Put this back together, and peel all that bad shielding out of there. Goodbye, Apple. I can't get this to fail on the bench without strings. $5 says when I put strings on it, it's going to do what it was doing before. I don't think so. I've said this before, bad shielding can actually make things worse than no shielding. You don't need anything around these. It's fine. Unless you put it right up against the fluorescent light bulb. Some good old Ronsonol, and I'll show you a little trick I use for getting this stuff off of there. Take yourself a piece of paper towel, and do that. That'll keep the Ronsonol on the sticker for a while. We'll just leave that for a minute or two. Now we'll clean up the frets. It doesn't need a complete fret leveling. A little bit of spot leveling in this area is going to take care of the minor amount of fret wear. And it's got those wonderful tape wound flats on it, so it's not going to wear anything anymore. Oh, the Apple has left the building. Well, we'll put the strings back on it and set it all up. Frets are all cleaned up.
and probably not gonna play it with that cover on it, but I will put the two holes and put it on the guitar, and the guy that owns it can take it off if he wants to.
Well, the old truss rod seems to be doing exactly what it needs to do. I'm not going to screw with that. Maybe after, maybe later. Let's get the string height correct. And, where's the hex key I need for that guy right here? Or maybe, is it that guy? It's that guy, I think. Or am I mistaken? Yeah, it is that guy. All right. Right back at you. While I'm doing this, I'll just remind everybody that all the great links to things that we love to keep Davey going are in the description. And, I got a sticker came back in the mail from Mr. B. Lear in Arizona. Return to sender, it said. And I hope you reach out to me. Is this like the second time I've sent this thing? Did you move? Or is it the bad mailman? The mailman hates you. This is what's going on. It's like Nick with his t-shirt. They kept it at the post office and then sent it back to me without telling them to come pick it up, even though they said they told them to come pick it up. Anyway, down below are the links to great stuff. Help me out. I'm really liking this. I'm not going to touch that anymore. Let's see what the intonation is like on this brand new spanky bridge. Actually, no, I digress. Let's check the pickup height, which seems to be too close. Oh, somebody's asking me about angling the pickups on a P-bass. The deal is, my understanding anyway, is that if you look at the older pickups where the poles are different heights, that's because back then magnets sucked and they didn't get better till later on. But now the magnetic material is such that I can't perceive any string not vibrating anything that's a magnet in there. Can I tell you? Still needs to maybe go down a little bit. I mean, I'll check it in the middle, but really, biggest problem is they always want to lean over on the foam. Retune it and do the intonation. It's good. Right out of the box. Brand new. They knew right where to put them. Amazing. Love it. What, that's about it, really. And, nonsense with the tone control. Anyway, folks, you saw it here. El Degas electric bass. Definitely there's some sort of lawsuit involved with this. Oh, I almost digressed a little bit too far. Let me put the little cover on. And I'm going to quit here in a minute because I got some other things I got to take care of. But I'm going to... like I said, although this is probably going to be taken off to play it, I'll put the two holes in the machine there so that you can have it on there for the bling factor if that's what you're after. And two screws away from getting it out of your way. I kind of like the rear one while I'm on talking about stuff. once upon a time I did usually play with a pick, and I found this really helpful, right, as opposed to resting on the bridge and ended up palm muting the strings and shit. It kind of worked out well. Anyhow, folks, I quit this kind. Well, almost, like I said, I got to drill a couple holes, but I think I'm burning my soup or dinner or something up there. I don't hear the fire engine yet, but we never know. So thanks for hanging out. And like I said, special shout out to my patrons. You can subscribe. That's easy. The Facebook group is still up. My page is not. I promise I'll make a new one soon enough. And with that, just so you can Twitter me too. And you can be safe and be good to each other. Cheers.